break this denial system. Okay? So this is the whole process which we will follow. Like, first step is acknowledgement. Like what we were doing is we were acknowledging all our masks, all our wounds, right? We'll acknowledge it and then we will embrace it. We'll not fight with it. Let's say I'm feeling angry. What will I do? I'll not fight with my anger. I will embrace my anger. I will feel my anger fully. Right? If I'm feeling sad. If I'm remembering certain situations and when tears are rolling down, I'll allow it. I will embrace it. I'll not bring the tears back. Understand? Crying is a very healing process. No, it ain't. This is a very beautiful thing. And Osho was telling, like, you know, woman had given everything to man. But one thing she did not do, crying. And that's the most beautiful thing. And man has lost it. And he lost life, the essence of life. How much ever the certain situations are, you know, woman can get through it because she cries. And man got stuck because he cannot mourn. And for me the biggest lesson was to allow my own tears coming down. You know? For me it was that fight for almost the whole depression thing, the whole self-sabotaging thing, the whole confusion thing was only two things. I did not accept my own anger and I did not accept my own sadness. I did not grieve. But that had kept me in that loop. That had kept me in the medication part, you know. That had kept me in that part of sleeping pills, frustration. You know, I could not know how to deal with it because all my life I told myself that, you know, I should not be angry. I should not cry. Right? And that had created all this confusion for me. So, in this workshop, we will see that whatever is coming up, we'll embrace it. So we trigger more many parts of ourselves, you know. Whatever is happening, let's say you are feeling angry, allow that anger to come. Become aware of that. If you want to shout, you are free to shout. I'm giving you that freedom and you give yourself that freedom. Want to cry, you are free to cry. And we create that safety here, right? And whatever comes in this room stays in this room. This cannot be used for manipulating us. Right? Let's say I want to earn love of Bhagyashri. So I will not use this story to manipulate her. Right? So that's the thing. And you need to do the same thing.
How?
To others. Whoever you love. You cannot manipulate, you know, you cannot do this game for love, you know, it should be pure, from the heart, feel from the heart. Basically, first we'll heal the heart, and especially we need to heal the heart. And when we heal the heart, you know, when we experience love, that's a very safe feeling. People get attracted to us naturally, and very, very beautiful space to be. And that's why first we will embrace all the wounds. And we will not use whatever is coming out in this room to manipulate, to blackmail others outside. Understand? Okay? And we'll accept whatever is coming. We first accept it. And then heal it. It's a process we undergo. We heal that. That part of that wound. Whatever is inside us, we completely resolve all the issues what we had in our life, in our past. And then we heal that part. And then when healing happens, transformation automatically happens. The change automatically happens. Now we are in a new space. A new space of peace, in a new space of love, in a new space of joy. Automatically happens, you know, we do not strive for it. When we heal this. And then at that point of time, we learn this masteries of love, masteries of peace, and we apply it again and again. That's how we keep this in, we be in this loop. continue this one. If you want to take a picture of it, you can take. This is the transformation cycle. We transform the wound and then we rise. Sunset,
sunrise.
Cycle. Again we rise and some other wound comes up. Again, sunset. We go deep inside, deep into the darkness and deep into that very core part of ourself. We will solve it, we will heal it, and again we rise. Making sense for everyone? If you have any questions, please feel free to ask.